Hi, my name is Alex, and in today's video, I'll be showing you how to create this poster inspired by Netflix limited series, The Queen's Gambit. This is a typographic poster, and I'll be happy to show you how it was done. So let's jump right in and add a background color. Go to Adjustment, Solid Color, and choose this color on Offset of Black. Let's add a new layer. Go for the brush, B for the brush tool, and I already have some smoke brushes installed on Photoshop, so you might want to have some available to you. Let's choose this color. This is the color, and paint right here. Now that we've added some smoke to the background, let's add the gesso board. You just have to drag and drop. Okay, let's make it bigger. Something like that. Adjust accordingly. Okay, Control or Command A and align center and horizontal. Okay, let's reduce the opacity, like 10%. Control or Command U to desaturate. Okay, so let's add some blur, Gaussian blur. Maybe like that, I'm not sure. We can always come back and change the Gaussian blur because this is a smart object. If you don't have a smart object, right click, choose convert to smart object. Okay, but I have to go back because I already had a smart object. And if you double click, you can always come back and change whatever adjustments you made. Let's add a little bit of depth. So new layer, B for the brush tool, choose a soft round brush. Reduce the hardness and let's add the highlight. Control Command T to bring the transform tool and make it bigger. Let's apply some Gaussian blur and choose another layer style, maybe overlay soft light. Let's go with overlay. New layer, B for the brush tool, choose the black color. And let's add some vignette, clicking on the side of the canvas. Okay, maybe something like that. Blur, Gaussian blur, always add some blur, no sharp edges. Okay, you can make it bigger. Choose another blending style. Let's say soft light. Okay, so for now, let's say we are good. Let's add the text. Text is the Queen's, first of all. Make it a lot bigger. Choose another color. This is the hex code if you want to copy. Okay, make this a little bit smaller, maybe even smaller than that. Accept. This is the font. This is a paid font, but I have a subscription on the Envato Elements platform, and I didn't have to pay for this. You should check their website. I leave the link for the font in the description if you want to use it. Let's add the other text, Gambit, and make it a lot bigger. Thing like that. Make sure that the text from the bottom is aligned with the one above. This feels like alright to me. Align the text with the canvas. Control or Command A and align vertically and horizontally. Okay. Let's add another text, 64. This is from a quote. It's not the whole quote, but for fans this will make sense. Let's use this font, make it smaller, of course, to fit between these two. Okay, maybe a little bit smaller, so Control Command J to duplicate, or holding Alt or Option and drag it to the right. Control Command T, make it smaller, like so. And let's add the rest of the text. Make it a little bit smaller, something like that. Center this to, let's say we are finished with this text. Group it, Control or Command J, and align them. Regarding the text, we're all set. Let's add this chess piece. This is the queen. I have it right here. This is a 3D render from Envato Elements. Okay. Maybe we should make it smaller, like so. Let's add some depth to it. So first of all, new layer, B for the brush tool, go and choose the smoke brush, choose the same color. This is the hex code that I used, and apply some brush behind the chest piece. Then bring the opacity down, like 60%. Let's add some smoke on the chest piece itself. Choose opacity 70%, like so. And another layer, but now we can change the blending mode to, let's say, overlay and affect only the chest piece. We need to clip it. Hold Alt or Option between these two layers, left click, and now it's only affecting the chest itself, like you see. You can always add more if you want. Let's say that we're now finished with adjusting the queen's chest piece. Let's add some more depth, or let's add this effect to our poster. We need to bring a texture. This is one of the textures used. Okay, make it a lot bigger, like that. First of all, make sure this layer has no saturation, no color. So Control Command U and bring the saturation all the way down. Okay, let's choose another layer style, maybe overlay or soft light. We have to choose multiply. As you see, this texture has lots of cracks, so we need to bring them down. The way we do that, it's by bringing the spot healing tool. Choose the layer that we want to work on, and just brush over the cracks that you want to cover, like so. I will fast forward for you, and we'll see you in a few seconds. Okay, now we're back. We need to apply another texture. Okay, so we need to adjust it accordingly and choose another blending mode. Let's go with screen, and we need to reduce the opacity or the fill. I'll reduce the fill to about 50%, like so. Let's bring up a little bit of clarity for the chess board from behind. Okay, and let's add a little bit of smoke on the background, maybe like that. Okay, maybe reduce it a little bit, and now basically the design is finished. You can always play with the amount of blur for the background, or you can add a little bit vignette, like so. And basically this is it. If you want to have infinite assets, you should make an account to Envato Elements. I'll link down below. This is the chess piece that I've used in the design render, and you have this unlimited assets that you can use as a graphic designer. I believe this costs only $60 per month or something like that. You should definitely check their website. And another website that I recommend to you as a graphic designer will be Creative Market. They even have weekly free goods that you can use for free. if you have an account with them. I hope you enjoyed watching me. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions. I'll see you in the next one.